Hey everybody, this is Stephanie Janicek. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I have been wandering around Tumblr and I've discovered a lot of really great blog posts about the problems a lot of us have with the idolizing of Kylo Ren among a lot of fans, and I'm going to address the Renistans and the Raylo people, because you piss me off and you embarrass me. Anyway, I found this, and I'm sorry I can't remember who posted it, but first off, if you think Ben is some sort of a tragic figure, he's not. In fact, I'm going to quote this almost verbatim. This is a shitty rating of canon. Galaxy Far, Far Away clearly has concepts of democracy, individual worth, non-discrimination. There's no indication that the kind of slaughter that took place on Jeddah, Alderaan, and Hosnia is any less horrific to the characters of Star Wars than it is to us. Remember when the commandos hit the beach at Scarif and Rogue One shouted for Jeddah, Jeddah, as they jumped off the transport? The genocide of Jeddah provoked enough moral outrage that it became a rallying cry. What's a more natural reading that the inhabitants of this galaxy develop rules to match a moral revulsion of such carnage? Or that they just let genocide and mass murder slide because, we don't like it, but different structure, different folks, right? The latter adds nothing and serves no purpose other than to let Ben get off scot-free for his actions. You know, it really gets me angry, though, and this is, again, a blog. I did not write this. It's a blog from somebody else. Insisting that mass murder and torture are accepted acts of war in the world of Star Wars hollows out, she says Finn's character, but it hollows out everybody's character. From the original trilogy heroes who are clearly suffered for what happened, clearly, and one suffered more than anybody, that's Han. And other characters, Rey, who had nothing to do with Ben, at least now that we know of, and other people who saw what he did. I mean, it clearly affected Finn. He couldn't do it. And we have, you know, insisting that mass murder and torture are accepted acts of war in the world of Star Wars, hollows out their characters. If killing civilians and unarmed prisoners is a normal act of war, then what does it make people who walked away from it? Does it make them soft-hearted cowards or people who stand up for morality? Think about that. And then we have, I'm looking down a little more. This argument, such as it is, absolves Kylo Ren at the expense of other characters, and it's nonsensical and ugly as hell. I see you, Raylors, when you say you love Finn, but then you pull shit like this to show what you really think of him. I'm not talking about Finn, I'm talking about the whole heroic arcs of the original three heroes and what the movie was about. To sit there and excuse Kylo Ren from anything, from killing the kids at Luke's Jedi Academy, to ordering the mass murder of that village and killing Lor San Tekka, who was a family friend, to torture, abducting against her will Rey and torturing her. And no, for you Raylors, that is not the same thing as Han and Leia on the Millennium Falcon. That's not even close. One was romance and one is brutality, and on a scale that I would put with ISIS or any sort of brutal regime you could think of. And also then murdering his father, which is quite frankly, the most disgusting thing I've ever seen in Star Wars, and there's plenty of disgusting things that bad guys did, because people loved Han Solo. So you put this mass murderer who's unapologetic, who thinks he's right, and a lot of these people who are truly evil, and evil does exist, there are no gray areas. Those who stand in the gray area and let it happen are every much as at fault as those who perpetrate the crime. So anybody who talks about gray areas, and I'm talking to the woman who runs the Star Wars discussion page on Facebook. Anybody who sits there and supports that is amoral, and it's just as outrageous as the criminal who did it, that they're excusing. There's no excuse for what Ren did, because there are plenty of people who suffered, and he did not suffer at all. But there are plenty of people who suffered who suffered throughout the ages, who didn't turn out to be disgusting, vile, genocidal pukes. In fact, if you look at many of the people who perpetuated the Holocaust, and that's one of my favorite analogies, because art imitates life, Reinhard Heydrich wasn't an abused man. He was not. He was very cold, very callous, and he believed that he was doing was right. It wasn't. It wasn't right or moral in any sense of the word. And when I think about excusing Kylo Ren for anything he did, I think about excusing somebody like Reinhard Heydrich. And in some ways, Kylo Ren, being Snoke's enforcer, is kind of like Reinhard Heydrich, because Reinhard Heydrich was Hitler's enforcer. That's the reality. That's reality teaching you that evil is real, and sometimes it's very mundane, and sometimes if you're a soft-hearted slob, like some of you Reylo people are, and Kylo Ren fans are, you will let evil get past you and excuse it, and there's no excuse for it. None. So there's that. Let's talk about Reylo. When Star Wars was taken over by Disney, there has been a concerted effort to turn Star Wars into a girls-only show. In fact, Jar Jar Abrams himself has said, "I never knew a girl who liked Star Wars when I was a kid." I don't know what girls he was talking about, because I loved it. No, maybe, you know, I wasn't the one playing with Barbies, but I sure as heck had the Millennium Falcon. I had all the characters. I melted my Boba Fett figure, because that's what happens when he finally gets killed in a gunfight with Han. He melts. I had fun with that stuff. It was great. So Jar Jar Abrams saying that was an insult to me and a lot of other women who grew up with it. But turning it into a girls-only, diversity-only zone that only SJW-supporting, shallow-thinking people can watch, and chasing away the core audience that was there from the beginning, is madness, and that's exactly what they're doing. A lot of these girls who love the idea of Kylo Ren being saved by Rey, which literally makes me want to blow chunks. It's just this. First off, it's not Star Wars. That's not how you do romance. And second of all, it's stupid. It comes right out of the vampire bullshit that Anne Rice started decades ago with, her vampire books and Lestat and Louis and all the rest of this garbage. And then Francis Ford Coppola's is a masterpiece, and I do like this movie, but he turned Dracula into a more of a sympathetic anti-hero, and that's not what Dracula was. So we've got that. So my thing is, stop it, okay? You want that kind of crap, go watch Twilight. Rey is not Bella Swan, and that filth bag, Ren, is not Edward Cullen. You want that? You have it. Take it. You don't belong in Star Wars if that's what you want. I'm sorry. Okay? It actually did make more sense through The Force Awakens that Rey would be with Finn, because that just made sense. And it's an insult to you people are insulting, and I've seen you do it, to Finn's fans, bordering on bullying. Just stop it. You know, most of us don't like Kylo Ren. We don't get why you do, okay? So stop it. So I just wanted to address it. I don't really care what you think. If you're a Kylo Ren fan, I think there's something wrong with you. I look at you like I look at you know, the girls that used to follow the Charles Manson trial and show up, you know, to view their crush in action, sitting in the defendant's chair when he was on trial for what happened to Sharon Tate and the LaBiancas and all the rest of those people that his followers murdered. That's who you remind me of. You're sick people and you need help. I look at you Raylo people and say, you don't understand Star Wars. Go watch Twilight, please. There's no place for this stuff, at all. I look at you people who, you know, and I look at Disney who emasculated Han and Luke, who turned Leia into this woman who, you know, we're not, you know, she turned into this dry turnip, a general, because being a woman who lost everything, a leader in the Rebel Alliance, a woman who lost everything, who gained something better back, a family, Luke, a husband, Han, who loved her and adored her, and children, that somehow isn't good enough, all right, for you people. I'm sorry. For a lot of women, it is good enough. And Leia was the best feminist icon that I think has existed in movies. And George Lucas was great at writing her character. And you people calling him a chauvinist and saying he wasn't feminist enough are full of shit, okay? Because he gave us Leia. We didn't need anything else. We don't need an Admiral Haldo. We didn't need Rey to be a Mary Sue, and I'm sorry she was. And I like Rey a little more than I did back then, because now I understand her and I understand where she came from because I know who her parents are. But still, you know, you chased the guys away and they were your base. And I'm gonna tell you something, girls. If you can't hang with the boys, then don't try to take over their shit. Make your own shit up. Make up your own galaxy far, far away, but leave Star Wars alone, okay? You're ruining it, all right? This is Steph ranting again, but I had to get this off my chest because there are a lot of people out there that feel the same way, and I wanted to add my voice and say, keep ranting away, guys. Keep ranting away. This is our franchise. They can't take it. This is Steph signing out. See you around the galaxy.